Hello, so I would like to announce the project. So we are going to build a classifier. So we are going to build a classifier. So what does classifier do? So basically it looks at a instance. So basically you have some data. So there is some data. You need to assign one of several labels. So you need to tell if this data, for example, if this data is some news article, you need to predict, looking at the data, whether it is politics, whether it is sports, you know, whether it is action movie or something like that, you know, whatever you can think of. So this is a classifier. So now what we are going to implement as part of this classifier is called nav base classifier. Okay. So in particular, the classifier that we are going to nav base classifier has several types. It has Bernoulli slash multinomial nav base. Then it has Gaussian nav base. So if you implement actually the Gaussian nav base, it will be much faster. But for this project, I am happy if you choose this one. So if this is perfectly okay, so you can actually implement one itself as part of this project. Okay, so typically, these classifier problems are ones, if you look at the data, you will be easily able to tell whether it is politics, sports, action, things like that. But the thing is, when you have an automated system, a system that wants to run with minimum interaction from user, what you are supposed to do is you are supposed to look at the data and predict this in an automatic fashion. You don't want somebody to sit and check these things one by one, because this can be very time consuming. Okay, so that's the whole idea behind classifier. So the particular classifier that I want each of you to implement is called image classification. So you have what is the handwritten, you have handwritten label data. Okay, so that is basically you have some handwritten label data. So what does that mean? So you have you have basically an image, okay, image of size 28 cross 28. Okay, so I think that is, if I'm not wrong, this is 784 pixels. You have 784 pixels. So whatever you see on your computer screen, right, it's a pixel. Okay, so this particular monitor that you are seeing is actually 1980 cross 800 pixels. So 28 cross 28 is a very small size, maybe something of this size that I'm going to draw. It's some small box like this. So within this block box, you have several handwritten characters. A, you have maybe F and all these things. And also there is someone has actually gone through this entire data and actually manually labeled it, whether it is A or F. Okay, so this is labeled. So this is like we know what exactly that is. So that is also given, and then the image is also given. I hope this distinction is clear. Okay, so this is a single value assigned to this entire image of 784 pixels. Okay, and this is a single character, which is A to Z. Okay, so the file that I have shared with you is called as a comma-separated file. Comma separated values file, or it is called as a CSV file. Okay, so what it essentially has is several rows. Okay, so there are 1, 2, 3, 4, all these rows are there. In each row, you have basically the first number, first position is a value which is 0 all the way up to 25. Okay, so this is the first entry of this comma separated file, and then you have all the pixels of the image. Okay, so one row at a time. So so this is like so if you count from here, if 1, 2 and so on, the 28th value here will be the end of row 1. Then you have the next row, so row 2 begins. Okay, then like this, another 28, then row 3 begins. So all the way, so how many rows will be there? Since there are 28 cross 28, there will be final one will be row 28, and the data will be here. So this is the format of the comma separated value files. So in order to read a CSV file, what you need to know is a Python package called CSV. Okay, so that is one Python package. The second Python package that will be useful is called as Pillow. Okay, this is for image processing. So you import it by saying import PIL. Okay, so this is a second package. So using these two, so Pillow you can use to basically read all these images and read all these pixels, and you can make a small image out of it just to see how it looks. You know, it's good to have a sense of how this is happening. All right, so this is like the overall sketch of the problem. Okay, in the next video, we will discuss more of this.